morning, friends, dignitaries on the dais, especially the chief guest, my mentor, Mr. UP Singh, Secretary, Water Resources, who is heading very important mission in the form of Jal Shakti, Mr. Srivastav, Mr. Jindal, Ritu, and the organizers. First of all, let me thank Noida Authority, especially Ritu, for inviting me here and giving me this wonderful opportunity of not only sharing my thoughts, but also learning from this great initiative. You know, Noida, Greater Noida, and Yamuna, and yes, fourth city of DMIC, IIT, GNL. So these are like four cities in this district, very important, all futuristic city, where smartness is there, either by design, or smartness is being built in as a retrofitted strategy. And this type of summit basically help all these four cities in moving forward. Friends, we know cities are becoming engine of growth, especially in countries like India, where a lot of movement towards the city, lot of employment generation is happening in the cities. One data says that out of, we have about 31 to 32% of the population in cities, which is generating about 2/3 of our national income. And by 2013, 75% of our national income, of our GDP, will come from cities only. And when we are talking about figures like that, we need to have cities which can support innovation, which have the infrastructure best in terms of quality, be it social infrastructure, physical infrastructure, economic infrastructure, institutional, the people of the city, etc. And these four cities, they can actually become the role models for remaining Uttar Pradesh. I think when we look towards solution, so the smart city concept provides us some solution. But what is a smart city? So there is a different definition. You know, depending upon the level of development, it varies from people to people, city to city. So within this district, when I talk of the fourth city, DMIC, IIT, GNL, this is one city where smartness is built in its design itself. This city is smart by design. While the other three cities, Noida is taking the lead, Greater Noida is following Noida, and then Yamuna will follow. So these cities, they are much better in terms of infrastructure, in terms of planning, and their smartness can be easily brought in as compared to when we compare to our old cities. It may be Delhi, Ghaziabad, or Kanpur, etc. So when we talk about smartness, we think of digital solutions. We think how we can improve our infrastructure by improving digital interventions. And here we can talk about any other infrastructure, be it roads, electricity, water supply, sanitation. Ritu has given excellent examples of how innovations can be brought in these sectors. So when I talk about Greater Noida, our experiments in Greater Noida, I will talk about 3-4 initiatives which we have taken in Greater Noida, starting with solid waste management. That is a huge challenge. And till today, I believe that actually there is no perfect solution which is available to Indian cities. Because of our Prime Minister's emphasis on Swachh Bharat, and because of dynamic leadership provided by our Chief Minister, so UP cities are also these days doing lot of experiments on Swachh Bharat, on city sanitation, on solid waste management, and finding new solutions. In Greater Noida, we also have adopted the decentralized model so that we can basically achieve a zero waste, zero garbage city after the processing is over. And we have adopted the decentralized mode. So we have divided city into 3-4 functional divisions. One functional division is bulk waste generators, where like we categorize all our residential areas into 3 RWs, RW of category 1 and 2, which essentially means the builder societies and the group housing cooperative societies. Then bulk waste generators include the shopping mall, commercial establishments, institutional establishments, hotels, etc., school, colleges of larger than a particular size, where the responsibility has been given to them. Not only collect the waste in segregated form, which they have been doing till now, but also to process it within their campus and convert their colony into a zero discharge colony. Mr. UP Singh and I have been staying in New Motibagh, which is, I think, one of the first colonies in India, which is absolutely zero discharge if we talk about solid waste, liquid waste, sewerage waste, in terms of construction also. Whatever was the C&D waste, that was also used within that campus itself. So taking those models forward, so we have adopted where in decentralized model, there we will not see witness any huge, you know, garbage pile up which we see when you enter Delhi from any side. A decentralized model where the waste collected in a particular sector, in a particular colony, or bulk waste generator or sectors of Greater Noida will be processed within that sector itself through decentralized mode of composting and through material recovery facilities. The model was presented well by Noida here in Ritu. Second model which I wanted to talk about are basically making smart villages. Greater Noida has almost area roughly slightly more than Noida. Noida is has 20,000 hectares, we are at 22,000 hectares. And then there is Greater Noida Phase 2, which is bringing another 28,000 hectares, which will, of course, the master plan will be ready post March 2021. But then there are 124 villages. So if you don't convert these villages into smart villages, then the whole concept of development gets negated. So to make a beginning, we have selected smart 10 villages as potential smart villages. We have selected a consultant who is preparing a DPR, and we will try to convert these villages into smart, not only in terms of their societal issues, land related issues. We will try to convert them into zero litigation villages by solving all their issues, best of infrastructure, providing them digital connectivity, doing whatever is required so that they feel integrated with Greater Noida City. Then one more initiative is basically what is essentially provided to treat citizens or the public as shareholders rather than stakeholders. They are the real owners of the society. For that, we have launched some initiative experiments which are yielding good results, but at sub-district, sub-city level, at colony level. So first scheme which we launched is Friends of Greater Noida. So Friends of Greater Noida is basically harnessing the potential of thousands of, you know, erudite families staying in Greater Noida, well-educated professionals, retired officials from government sector, private sector. So if you want to become a friend of Greater Noida, you have to go to our website. You need to be a professionally qualified person. You need to be staying or working in Greater Noida. And you have some, you know, commitment. You want Greater Noida to be a better place to live or to work. And you can spare time. These people, they just don't give suggestions, but they come out with a specific problem, with some solution, they design it themselves. Most of them are architects, some of them are civil engineers, some of them are other activists. And then we implement the solution. We provide all the funding. We do it ourselves. They just bring in the design, they supervise us, they get it implemented. And it gives me happiness to share with you that if I talk in terms of Friends of Greater Noida Inc., the turnover today is about 70 crores. 70 crores worth of projects are being implemented through this Friends of Greater Noida. And these are absolutely volunteers working on pro bono basis, who face some problem in their sector or colony, and then they come out with solutions. And we try to implement that. Second, innovative solutions, you know, taking the city, basically converting the stakeholders into shareholders, is CEO forum. So we have lot many investors. You know, Noida is a city 15 years ahead of us in terms of industrial development. Greater Noida now is in its peak in terms of industrial development. So we saw there are many companies who have invested in Greater Noida. So when an investor takes risk on a particular city, that means he had some expectation. So we go back to all these CEOs. CEO means here the local head of a firm. It may be an industrial firm or some institution like a university. We go back to them, we talk to them, we find out with which expectation they invested in this city. Because of their professional education, within 10 minutes, They give us the problems and they give us, suggest us the solutions also. We try to implement them. We try to, they are our messengers. I will just cite you one example. So when new investor comes to us, sometimes they have questions to ask on different aspects. So if we feel that we are not able to satisfy them fully, we divert them to one of our CEOs, basically of the CEO forum. So one big firm who had minds whether to invest in Hyderabad, Chennai or Greater Noida. So we referred him to one of the like CEOs. They wanted to find some information and rest, the trick was done by that particular CEO of our CEO forum, and that investment came to Greater Noida. So we are getting so much investment that we have sold all of our industrial land. We are purchasing 1500 acres of industrial land to develop four new industrial sectors and then another four new sectors lined up after that. And if you know, investments flowing to Greater Noida, Greater Noida will be, Greater Noida and this Noida, Yamuna, the sole region of four cities, will become the largest hub of mobile manufacturing, of white goods manufacturing, etc. Third initiative which we started is because in terms of, again I said, professional institutionals, professional education. We have four universities, we have engineering colleges, we have architect colleges, we have so many colleges, you know, doling out educations. So we involve them in our decision making. We went to them because I found that in India the academia and the practitioner engagement was very low. So we offered the whole of city, we offered the whole of authority to these organizations as an experiment ground, as a laboratory. We requested the students basically to do internships with us. So whenever there is a problem, we basically solve it, we refer it to the universities. We organize once every year hackathons with them during our carnival. This time also a hackathon will be organized at Sharda University. They find solutions. Last time the theme of this hackathon was Happy Greater Noida, how to make the Greater Noida into happiness, increase the happiness quotient. This time it is Smart Greater Noida. So Alpha, they are doing projects like, you know, Alpha Market Revival, Alpha One Market Revival. There is no place to hang out, you know, in the common places. So Alpha One Market, they have, the students have developed a project which we will implement very soon. So if there is a Parichonk traffic problem, we referred it to the students. Students have to come out with a solution, short-term solution, medium-term solution and long-term solutions. Then we talk about basically to convert the, if you have to convert a city into smart city, into a city which is thriving business, where people can successfully engage. So the authority, the municipality, the functionaries will need to become smart. So there we are implementing ERP system through Tech Mahindra, which will be implemented by the end of the March 2020. We are implementing the GIS solution, which will be implemented by June 2020. And when these two solutions will be implemented, some of the services offered by authority will be available. These powers stand delegated to the our allottees. You know, it may be an allottee of a residential house, allottee of an industrial house. For example, getting just a no-due certificate. Today, if I also intervene, it will take minimum 2 to 3 days. Normally, take 10 days, 15 days. Sometimes we send our challans to the bank for verification in the era of digital technologies. When we are leader of UPI in whole of the world, still we do some of these things. But the ERP, this person can just by click of mouse, can print a digitally signed no-due certificate, maybe permission to mortgage, and do many other things. Like through internet banking, the branch manager's powers have been delegated to the like account holder. Similarly, many of the powers will stand delegated to the allottees, and for citizen services, there will be, of course, app-based. We run an Mitra app now also to get all the problems being faced by citizens and provide solutions. Now, lastly is basically applying smart solutions to infrastructure and services, which Ritu has talked. We are also doing some of these projects. First is like Greater Noida Wi-Fi. Basically, you have to ensure these days Wi-Fi, internet, this is solution to many problems. So, but every citizen, I feel that it will become like a fundamental right, you know, of every Indian to have Wi-Fi or an internet as a service. So we are starting with by providing Greater Noida Wi-Fi. Our RFP is ready. We are ready to float any day now. So we have selected some hotspots and 10 villages. 10 villages, as I told you earlier, we have selected for potential, you know, smart villages. So we will start by providing this Greater Noida Wi-Fi to these hotspots. Second is new signage policy we have approved recently. So there will be single type of signages all over Greater Noida, only implemented by the authority, rather than today any person comes and then he will, you know, try to disturb the balance, the aesthetics of the city by installing his own signage in front of his house, shop or whatever. We have hired consultants for preparing like intelligent traffic management solutions, city surveillance system, smart parking, and one project which will be soon we will be rolling out again on water supply, converting the water supply into smart water supply by institution of smart meters and sensor based technology on Internet of Things. Basically, when I talk about ERP, GIS, and we are preparing reports on Internet of Things, also making everything smart, as I said. Lastly, because street lighting also, we are converting now into basically smart and energy efficient LED lighting. And then Greater Noida is very, very green in terms of green belts. If you see wide roads, but along with very wide green belts, 18% of our land use is earmarked for green belts, and it has become a huge challenge for us to maintain those green belts so that people can go and spend time there. So we have adopted a model of taking CSR help. Recently we signed an agreement with HCL Foundation. Earlier we signed agreements with many multinationals and big industrial units of our place, like Honda Powers, Honda Motors, Honda CL, New Holland. Everyone is helping us. All these units, Oppo, they are helping us in terms of green belt maintenance, and these results will be very visible very soon on the ground. Lastly, 2 points I want to talk about. One is about public spaces. When we talk about something, public spaces are very, very important. You know, I went for a training to Berkeley and then I was moving around in San Francisco. So I was surprised to learn in San Francisco, they destroyed whole one road. It was like, I think, 2-3 kilometers bridge, because they took a decision that the city, the public places, the city belongs to its citizens. The public, the Bay Area, the waterfront, it belongs to the public. So if you go to many beaches in India, you will find that 5-star hotels also, like, you know, they will be having a beachfront. But here they said the whole waterfront belongs to the public, and they constructed a waterfront. If there is a hotel like this, they will construct a 6 feet front view for the public. So in cities, like when we talk about cities like Noida, Greater Noida, etc., here public spaces are in the form of public parks, you know, other places where one can go and enjoy without maybe paying any fees, etc. Some of the other facilities which sometimes become accessible to only few people. So that should be made available to every citizen of the city. That also is very, very important. Lastly, as I told earlier, so there is one example here. So some people, I purposely brought, because some people generally we call it Tri-City, but this is fourth city. So I am CEO of that also. This is DMIC IIT JNL. This is a 50-50% venture. So this is about 750 acres, about 40 kilometers from here. Like smart by design, I said everything is SCADA based, water, electricity, so much so. Like we talk about solid waste management as the huge challenge being faced by all cities of India. So it is smart by design, which simply means that every house, every plot, be it industrial plot, commercial plot, residential plot, will have just two pipes coming from the central processing facility into each house, each plot, and you just have to throw the garbage in those two holes, those two pipes. They will be compressed and that will be sucked through those pipelines, SCADA based system, to the central processing facility. So here smartness is built into the design. It is probably one of the smartest cities being ready. We have sold 150 acres of industrial land. Slowly we will be coming out with commercial, residential there. The idea is that people will just walk or cycle to their workplace. It's 750 acres of integrated city. So that is one example very near where we can go and learn also. But ultimately here, out of these four cities, Noida will have to take the lead, because Noida has already taken the lead in terms of innovative models which they have implemented, and with the joining of Ritu, this thing has taken a lot of thrust. It is moving forward. So when these four cities, Noida, Greater Noida, Yamuna Authority and DMIC, IT General, I am sure they will become a model for other cities of Uttar Pradesh, other cities of India, and workshops like this, seminars like this, basically provide a lot of learning opportunities for all of us. And I once again thank Ritu for organizing such a wonderful initiative. Thank you very much. Thank you.